Hello everybody, and welcome to part 17 of my Mass Effect playthrough. This is any given game. Can't even say my own name. Alright, is there anybody
Ships
else here
are already
we want
on
to talk
their way
to?
Here with supplies.
All traces of the Thorian will be erased in short order. Ferris will have a second chance thanks to you. Commander, glad to see you survived your encounter.
I fought so hard, but any thought of my own caused so much pain.
We can rebuild this place. We're stronger than the company gives us credit for.
I wish we'd been
I will
able
do
to
what
all,
I can to assist
the
colony in this difficult time. I am ashamed of the damage done to the lives of these people.
Farewell, Shiala.
Farewell, Commander. I wish you well in your hunt.
She said her name weird. Shiala. Alright, let's keep going. I guess we're done here.
Thank you for freeing us.
Now we're done with Pharos. Let's check the journal. Oh, yeah, we gotta do the Rogue Eye. Let's go do that next. And then we'll go to Vermeier. Wait, is it the wrong way? No, it's this way.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress. Decontamination in progress. Decontamination in progress.
Again? Really? Why does it always take so long to get out of here?
Decontamination in progress.
I think this is their way of telling me I need a bath.
Commander, you look pale. Are you suffering any ill effects from the cipher?
My brain's been scrambled like an egg. How do you think I feel?
I might be able to help you. I am an expert on the Protheans. If I join my consciousness to yours, maybe we can make some sense of it.
Do it. Hurry. We don't have much time.
Relax, Commander. Embrace eternity! That was incredible. All this time, all my research, yet I never dreamed. I am sorry. The images were so vivid. I never imagined the experience would be so intense. You are remarkably strong-willed, Commander. What you have been through, what you have seen, would have destroyed a lesser mind.
Did you see anything?
The beacon on Eden Prime must have been badly damaged. Large parts of the vision are missing. The data transferred into the Commander's mind is incomplete.
You sure you didn't come across any kind of clue or hint? Something we might have missed?
Everything I saw, you already know. You were right about the Reapers. The Protheans were destroyed by a race of sentient machines. I think it is obvious there is a connection between the Reapers, the Prothean extinction, and the Conduit. But I did not see anything that would help us find it.
What's our next move?
I was able to interpret the data relayed through your vision, what was there at least, but something was missing. Saren must have the missing information. Maybe he found another beacon. If we can find the missing data from your vision, I can... Oh, I am sorry. The joining is exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
We're done here. Dismissed.
I've sent off the Pharos report, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
Commander, Exogeny should have told us about the Thorian. It would have made your job much easier.
You might have been able to capture it for study instead of destroying it.
The only reason to study a creature like that is to figure out how to kill it.
Yes, kill it. That's how you humans usually deal with things you don't understand.
The Thorian enslaved and killed innocent civilians.
Perhaps it's for the best, then. At least the colony was saved.
Of course it was saved. Shepard would go to any lengths to help a human colony.
Goodbye, Counselor.
Oh, lost the connection, ma'am. Sorry.
Thank you, Joker. I really wish he was a romanceable option. I would definitely pick him. Alrighty, let's go talk to everybody like usual.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
Alliance medical personnel take courses in alien biology, just in case.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
Maybe we could pick up where we left off. You were telling me about your interest in the Protheans.
Actually, I think I was talking about my interest in you, and making a fool of myself in the process. As I said, I am not used to dealing with people, especially humans. I did not really know much about your species when we first met, Shepard. I found it hard to take humanity seriously. Your kind always seemed so rushed and high-strung.
Has your opinion changed at all?
It has. I have been watching you and your crew. It has taught me a lot about your species. You humans are creatures of action. You pursue your goals with an almost indomitable determination. It is an admirable trait, but also an intimidating one.
You can't argue with results.
No, but there are consequences. Unfortunately, the rest of the galaxy sees humanity as a bully. You run over anyone who gets in your way. It is up to people like you to change their minds, Shepard.
Why me?
There is a reason the Council chose you to become a Spectre. They saw something special in you. The best of what humanity has to offer. I looked into your history. I know what you did on Torfin. I cannot even imagine how horrible that must have been, but you did what had to be done.
Why are you so interested in me?
I wanted to know more about you. To understand what made you into the woman you are. There is something compelling about you, Shepard.
You're interested in me because of my visions. You just want to know more about the Protheans.
I admit, your connection to the Protheans had something to do with my initial interest, but it has grown beyond that. You intrigue me, Shepard, but I was not sure if it was appropriate to act on my feelings. I thought there might already be a relationship between you and Lieutenant Alenko.
I care about Caden. A lot.
I thought so. Still, I feel as if there is also some attraction between us, Shepard.
I'm not interested in you in that way, Liara.
This is very embarrassing for me, Commander. Please, let's talk about something else.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Ugh, poor Liara. She's always sort of flirty with you, even if you just remain friends. Like in the second and third games, she gets sort of flirty. Which I guess is just how Asari are. But, and I like Liara well enough. I don't really like her romance. Like I've done it before and it wasn't interesting.
We haven't had time together since our last chat.
lot was said when we talked.
You seemed decisive then, Lieutenant. Why so hesitant now?
I don't want to distract you too much. The deeper we get into this mess, the bigger it seems. I'm just looking for an ear. The debriefing wasn't the right place to say how ridiculous this is. Seems like every other race in the galaxy is wrapped up in their own problems. They don't want to see what's coming.
Wanting to believe everything will be fine? Sounds like human nature to me.
Yeah, I guess some things carry across species well enough. I should remember that after what happened with Vernus.
I think you'd carry a grudge over the crap you took from Vernus.
Before I met Vernus, I knew as much as any other civilian. Aliens were weird, superior, and tried to tell us what to do. I mean, it's only been 26 years since first contact. That's not a lot of time to understand them. But it was Vernus who made me see how human aliens are. They're not different or special. They're jerks and saints, just like us. Hell, by the time I got payback, I didn't even want it anymore.
I don't see you snapping very easily. What finally did it?
He hurt Rana. Broke her arm. She reached for a glass of water instead of pulling it biotically. She just wanted a drink without getting a nosebleed, you know? Like an idiot, I stood up. Didn't know what I was gonna do, just something. And Vernus lost it. Beat the crap out of me. Kept shouting how they should have bombed us back to the Stone Age. And that's when the knife came up. A military-issue talon, right in my face. I cut loose. Full biotic kick right in the teeth. Almost as strong as I can manage now. At 17, that's something.
You wanted to help a girl you cared for. That's a noble thing.
Maybe my intentions were noble, but I lost control. I killed him, Shepard. Snapped his neck. They probably could have saved him if they got him to an infirmary quick enough, but they didn't. Caused a stir when they shipped him home. Bot training was shut down. Kinetics folded a couple of years later. That's funny. I'm not sure which of us got the worst of what happened.
Was Rana all right?
Rana? Yeah. Yeah, she was fine. We never really, we stopped talking after that.
Tell me what happened.
Rana had a gentle heart. She loved everyone. Vernus terrified her. We all protected her from him, and everyone loved her. But after what I did to him, she was terrified of me too. Anyway, this is, I had a point here. Aliens are individuals. Just because one's an ass doesn't mean they all are. So, yeah, I hated that Turian, but he wasn't a Turian to me. He was Vernus.
So that's why you're so self-controlled.
I'm no more disciplined than any other biotic, Shepard. This is all ancient history. I'm over it.
You agonize over doing the right thing and never let yourself lose control. Because Rana spurned you after Vernus died.
That's... all right. Maybe you have a point. Maybe. But I'm okay. You don't have to worry about me. Fully functional human being. And I won't be a burden on you. On the crew.
Caden, you're a strong man. Talking about this doesn't make you a whiner, and it doesn't make you immature. It makes you human.
All right, but it's embarrassing you had to tell me that. You're right. I might need to loosen up a little. I'll try. Glad you'll be here when it's over, Shepard. I'm looking forward to some shore leave.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
I'm glad there aren't many aliens like the Thorian. I don't think my stomach could take it. Hell of a deal you worked out with Jong, though. If I ever get a speeding ticket, I want you to be my advocate.
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I've wasted enough of your time for now, Commander. We'll have time for personal debriefings later.
We'll talk later, Caden.
I'd like that.
Thank you. Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you got.
You bet, Commander.
Combat optics? Nah. I already have that equipped, I think. A really weak one, yeah. Alright, I guess we're done here.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Something bothering you?
It's Saren. I'm starting to wonder whether we'll ever find him. He's always one step ahead of us, and he's got those damn Geth.
We're getting close, Garrus. We'll find him.
I wish I had your confidence. I just can't stand the thought of him getting away with everything he's done. I know you're doing everything you can, and if anyone can catch him, it's you, but if there's anything else I can do to help, anything, just tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it.
I understand your concern, but we will find him. Just make sure you're ready to go when we do.
Yes, ma'am. You can count on me. Thanks for hearing me out. I appreciate it. Can I ask you something, Commander?
What is it?
Are you worried that the Council might be protecting Saren? I mean, they were really dragging their heels before. What if we find him, bring him back to the Citadel, and they refuse to act?
You seem to have some thoughts on this. Speak your mind, Garrus.
Well, maybe we shouldn't give them the chance, Commander. In my opinion, Saren's too dangerous to be kept alive. Too much could happen. He could escape, or the Council might let him go. If we find him, when we find him, I say we make sure we stop him, permanently.
I'm glad you see it that way. I never had any intention of capturing that bastard. When I see him, he dies.
Good. The Council won't like it, but they can't stop you either. You see, this is why I want to be a Spectre. You never have to worry about bureaucratic idiots making a mess of everything.
Just make sure you're ready when it happens.
Yes, ma'am.
Commander?
What's your opinion of the last mission?
Gotta admire those Colonials. That's about the worst place for a colony I've ever seen. Given the option, I'd get the hell out of Dodge.
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
I'm off duty until tomorrow. I was gonna have a small drink. Bit of a celebration. If you're interested.
What's the occasion?
It's Armistice Day, when the First Contact War ended. My family always marks it. Since I'm the only Williams aboard, I thought I'd ask you.
You can't think I'm the most patriotic person on the ship.
Nah, you just happened by at the right time. Don't tell me you don't know about my family. My commanders always find out. It's not in my files or something?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm General Williams' granddaughter, the commander of the Shanxi garrison in the war. The only human ever to surrender to an alien race.
Don't tell me you're blamed for that.
Not formally. Dad got passed for promotion over and over. And I think my record merits more than garrison duty in a backwater agri-colony. Takes a special kind of thick-headed to march into a job where your family's blacklisted. I did it anyway. I'm not gonna let our name go down with Arnold and Quisling. Granddad deserved better than that.
As I recall, your grandfather held out for a long time.
The Turians wrecked the orbitals in the first wave, and occupied the major cities. They sat in orbit, dropping rocks on anything that moved. Granddad dispersed the troops, but when they went into the cities for supplies, the Turians would wreck a block to eliminate one fire team. Civilians were dying, his troops were starving, and he couldn't contact Alliance High Command. So he surrendered the garrison.
What happened to your grandfather after the war?
He was relieved of command as soon as Shanxi was liberated. They brought him back to Earth in irons. But there was never a trial. They quietly demoted him and stuck him behind a desk. He retired a year later and spent the rest of his life working construction in the colonies. Sometimes we hear about attempts to get him exonerated in some official way. Nothing ever comes of them.
Is this why you're always going on about the Council?
If everyone else can look at Shanxi and say, this is why humanity needs to be stronger, then so can I. I'm entitled. So now you know. Gonna kick me off the ship, Skipper?
You're part of the team, Williams. I don't care what your grandfather did or didn't do.
Not to get all cheesy, but you're the first CEO who's ever said that to me. Thanks, Skipper. But anyway, I've got things to do before we land. I'm sure you do too.
Dismissed, Chief.
Ma'am.
Shepard?
So you'd rather be a merc than help your people?
I'm a fighter. It's what I do.
Aren't you at all worried about what will happen to the Krogan?
What the hell do you want me to do about it, Shepard? I'm tired of sticking my ass on the line and getting nothing for it.
So you decided to go your own way?
I decided killing for credits was better than killing for a lost cause. I'm no hero, Shepard. Bottom line, killing for credits simplifies things.
Exactly. That's why I hired you.
And that's why I joined, so I wouldn't have to deal with them. But there's a lot of Krogan mercs out there. I'm always running into them. Half the time I'm being paid to kill them. But that's just part of the job. You don't get to pick who your enemies are.
How long have you been a merc?
Long enough. I took my first contract right after I left my home system. It's good work. It doesn't kill you.
I get the feeling you enjoy your work.
Sure. You get to see the galaxy on someone else's credits, and most days end with a good fight. I've tried more organized fighting, private armies and such, but it gets too messy. I fight best on my own, or in very small groups. I don't like people relying on me, and I bloody well don't like relying on them.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
It feels like we're getting near the end, doesn't it, Shepard? With Saren, I mean.
If we don't stop him soon, it'll be too late.
You'll find the conduit before he does. I know you will. You have to. And after this is all over, when my pilgrimage ends and I go back to my own people, I'll be proud to say I was a part of it.
Saren's still got a couple more surprises waiting for us.
Yeah, I get that feeling too. But I know you can handle whatever he throws at us. And I'll be right here if you need my help.
I should go.
See you later.
Hey, Commander, next time we touch down, let's try not to park the ship in a colony of mutant zombies. Just thinking out loud here.
I have to go.
All right, see you.
Thank you.
Check it out, we're in the solar system. I don't know, I always get so happy about this. There's no Pluto though. Oh wait, actually I think there might be, I see two. Yay, they put Pluto in. All right, now we're going to, yeah, they changed the name of the moon to Luna. So yeah. On the moon! You know, we go to all kinds of planets all over the galaxy, but I always get so excited when we go to the moon. There's Earth! Oh, that is so cool. Everything.
Perimeter secure.
Alrighty, we're coming up short on time, and this mission can take a little while. So I'm going to end it right here and see you guys in the next part.